In this slide, we will be discussing about the collision and the hash collision and hash collision resolutions. Suppose we want to add a new record R with key K to our file F, but suppose the memory location address H of K is already occupied, that memory location is already occupied by any previous hash values. So in this situation, it is known as hash collision. Basically, this is defined as the situation where a newly inserted key maps to an already occupied slot in the hash table, and there must be some steps to avoid this collision, and these methods are known as collision handling techniques or collision resolution. That is, if x1 and x2 are two different keys, it is possible that h of x1 may be equal to or is equal to h of x2. This situation is collision where more than one record expecting for the same index value. This collision resolution is the most important issue in hash table implementations. The hash function minimizes the number of collisions and has hashes uniformly to solve the critical issue. Here we have the keys, that is the name of the students. We have to store their records in the memory allocation. So here we can see the memory allocation allocated by the hash function for John Smith is also equal to the memory allocation allocated to Sandra D. That is 125. The hash value for both the keys is 152. So we cannot store the same in that memory location. We cannot store these two keys, datas of two keys. So we have some of the methods by which we can solve this collisions. So basically, there are two broad ways of collision resolution. One is separate chaining, another is open addressing. Separate chaining is about an array of linked list implementations, whereas open addressing is about array based implementations. That is also known as closed hashing. So, under open addressing, it is basically divided into three types, that is linear probing, quadratic probing, and double hashing. We will have a elaborate study about what is the first method, that is separate chaining, or also known as open hashing. The separate chaining is one of the most commonly used collision resolution techniques. It is usually implemented using linked list. In separate chaining, each element of the hash table is a linked list. To store the elements in the hash table, you must insert it into a specific linked list. If there is any collision, that is two different elements have same hash value, then we have to store both the elements in the same linked list. So here is the example. For example, the keys are 0, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, and 81. And where we get the, in any case, we get the same hash value, such as in the case of 81 and 1, we get the same hash value of 1. So it is stored, it is represented in form of a linked list. Here you can see in the diagram, for example, 36 and 16 will have the same hash value 6. Then again, it is stored in the form of linked list, in which the data part is the first element and the link part will allocate to the next data element or the key element, that is 16. So this is how we represent the, or we resolve the collision problem by using open hashing or separate chaining. Next, we have open addressing or close hashing. Open addressing is done in following ways, that is linear probing, again we have quadratic probing, and we have double hashing. So we will start with the linear probing. In linear probing, we linearly probe the next slot. For example, the typical gap between two probes is taken one, as we will be seeing one example. So here what is been taken, if the slot hash function of S is full, that is the element X percentile S is full, then we can see for X plus 1 value percentile S. If X plus 1 value is also occupied or full, we can try for X plus 2 position percentile S. X plus 2 position is full, then we can try for X plus 3 position. Okay, this is how the element will be switched to the next memory allocation. So we will see one simple example of by solving this open addressing of linear probing using this set of keys. So here we go. First we will be inserting 76. So the mod we have taken 7, that is, I have already told, the size of the table is also taken as the m value, that is x mod m. So m value here is the size of the table, that is 7. So 76 percentile 7, that is 6. So 76 is stored in the memory allocation 6. Again we have to insert 93. So 93 percentile 7 is 2. Again 93 is stored in the memory allocation 2. Again we have the memory address 40. 40 is percentile 7 is 5. So 40 is stored in 5. Whereas again we have to store 47. Now 47 percentile 7 is 5, okay, but 5 is already occupied. So here it will be transferred to 48. 48 percentile 7, it is already told the index value will be incremented by 1. So it was 47, it will be incremented to 48. Now 48 percentile 7 is, the remainder is 0. Okay, not 0. The remainder will be, for 48 it will be 6. But 6 is also already occupied. So it will be 49. When it will be 49, then the memory allocation will be 0. Because 49 is divided by 7 and we don't get any remainder. So it will be 0 and 47 is inserted here. Same in the case of 10, when 10 divided by 7 we get the remainder 3. 3 is empty, so 10 was inserted. But here in the case of 55, the remainder is first of all 6. But 6 is occupied, so 56 will be implemented. While 56 is implemented, again the remainder is 0, which is occupied. Again by using 57, we get the remainder as 1, and here 55 is inserted in the memory allocation 1. So this is how we do linear probing. Next, we will move to the next collision resolution technique, that is quadratic probing. In quadratic probing, the hash value X is added to the formula, that is the power form. Hash plus 1 to the power 2. then 2 to the power 2, then 3 to the power 2. This is how it has been added. So it is just simple as that the x value or the index value is added to power of 1 power of 2, then 2 power of 2, then 3 power of 2, and the value changes so as the index value also changes. So we'll see one simple example. We have to insert 76. So 76 was divided by 7 and we got the answer 6. It is inserted. In case of 40, the value was 5 and it is inserted. In case of 48, the value was 6, but 6 is already occupied. So 48 plus power 1 power 2, that is 49. So after 49, we got the value 0 here. So 48 is stored here. Again, we have to insert 5. While 5 percentile 7, we get the answer as 5. So 5 is already occupied. Again, it will be added to 1 power 2. The key value will turn to 6. So again, 6 is also occupied. Again, by powering 2 to the power 2, the value is 4. 5 plus 4, we get 9. After 9 percentile 7, we get the value as 2. So here at the position 2, 5 is inserted. So this is how quadratic probing is done. Example of quadratic probing is explained. Whereas same in the case of insertion of 55 is also done. At the very last, we have another collision technique, that is double hashing. In double hashing, we use the formula, that is the index value is added the one value multiplied index of another hash function. Okay, first hash function value is there. If that is already preoccupied, we will need the address of another hash function. For example, we are already using the division method, and the next step we will be using the folding method. Okay, so this is how the double hashing technique is or formula is been used. So here is the example. You can see that is how double hashing is done. When the element is already occupied, for example, here in the case of 47, this you can simply find there is no repetition, so it is easily been added. But here in the case of 47, there is 47 mod 7 and the value is 5. Okay, when the value is 5, 5 is already preoccupied, so what we need to do? 5 will be added to the hash function of any other formula, and finally we get the element value as 3. Okay, the result, whatever outcome it took, is 3. So in the position of 3, 47, okay, this value of 47 percentile 5 in some other method we got 3. Okay, so in that case the value changed and the output we got is 1. So at the position of 1, 47 is inserted. Okay, so I think you have got it, that how it is done. Where here in the double hashing we will be using two hash functions. For example, one may be any of the three. One may be the division method, another can be the folding method, or here we have studied about double hashing and the three techniques, that is quadratic probing and linear probing, in order to solve the collisions. Hope this video is helpful for you. Thank you so much.